Wayne Forshey needs a kidney, and he took the opportunity of being at the annual experimental aircraft fly-in in Oshkosh, Wisconsin, where close to 500,000 people congregate every year to pitch for one. I'll let Wayne tell you his story.
So I knew that my kidney function had been diminished, but I had a doctor that swore I could take 4 extra strength ibuprofen a day and it wouldn't hurt me. Well, ibuprofen is excreted through the kidneys, and I was also taking Prevacid for acid reflux. And I have no doubts that had I not taken those medicines, my kidneys would still be functioning. But I'm an A&P mechanic and an IA, and I was at the IA renewal in Columbus, Ohio, and an FAA man came over and said, there's a policeman that needs to talk to you. And I thought, well, I parked in the right spot. I can't imagine why they want to do that. So I walked over, and he said, you need to go to the hospital right away. We got a hold of you, your brother got a hold of us and told us that your doctor said that you needed to go. So this was on March 19th, 2015, and I live in southeastern Ohio, close to Wheeling, West Virginia. I said, I can't get out of here until 5 o'clock. But I left at 5 o'clock, drove across town to the east side of Columbus, and my wife was waiting at Mount Carmel East Hospital when I walked in. So I walked in, and they admitted me, and they said, your kidney function is below 8%. You need to go on to dialysis right now. So they put what they call a hero catheter basically in my carotid artery, and on the 20th I had my first dialysis session, and then on March 22nd, my 60th birthday, I spent it in the hospital. I stayed with my brother from the release of the hospital in March through July in Columbus and dialyzed, and then I went home, and now I dialyze in Marietta, Ohio. And I asked a woman right in the beginning, I said, how long did it take you to start to feel normal? And she said, well, over a year. Well, my wife had her work schedule rearranged to take me to dialysis 3 days a week, and she was working the other 4, and it was just killing her. I got some Brother Knights of Columbus members to help me last summer take me, and then this February I started driving myself. I'm on the active transplant list at Ohio State University. Before I came to Oshkosh, I had 2 people that were willing to go through testing to be a donor. The third one happened at McDonald's here in Oshkosh 2 evenings ago when I went through the drive-thru. The girl in the drive-thru said, you need a kidney? And I said, yes. She said, I'll give you one. So I got her name and number, and I'm going to send her some contact information. But I'm A negative. And my understanding is that I do not have to have a perfect match donor. If I can find any donor, they will exchange that kidney for one that I can use. So that's my story.
Okay, now you turn around and let's see your advertisement or your promotion. Okay.